Okay, so let us start the theory of computation. Let us discuss the unit one. Already some of the classes you joined, unit two only you joined some of the classes. You know the idea of the subjects. So what we are doing in the subjects, we are simply solving the problems. Subject, you can understand the nature of the subject. It is to solve the problems. So theory of computation means it is used to solve the problems. That is the idea of the theory of computation. And you can understand the meaning, theory of computation. Computation means what? Some calculations. Computation means it's a calculations. Like theory of computation, it's a theoretical computer science. So last ticket, previously before computer exists, this computer, whether whatever computer using, before that there was a theoretical concepts. There are problems which was solved by using the mathematical notations. Our mathematical professors and computer scientists together joined a lot of problems in the computer science field. So that is why the theoretical computer science is very important subjects. It's a core subject of computer science. If you study this subject, then it is easy to understand other subject, because most of the subjects are derived from this particular subject only. For example, computer design is one of the subject. And pattern matching related subject, whatever web technology you are studying, whatever languages you are studying, everything for every subject, and this will be the core subject. This is a core subject. From this subject only, other subjects are derived. So this is a very important subject. You have to learn it properly. And theoretical computer science is a major part. It was helped the computer science scientists to solve n number of problems in this field. So that is why you have to give the importance to the subject. Improve your logical skill, logical thinking. It will improve your the way how to solve the problems, and you can understand how logically you have to derive the solutions, and then how you have to find out the solutions by doing the modeling. So modeling, in the sense, it is simulation. You know the meaning of the simulation or modeling. Like this, you have a big problem like this. That problem, you have to solve this problem. How you can solve? You follow some steps. So step by step, you will find the solutions. So like computations, we have a problem. For the problem, you have to find the solution. That is the importance of the subject. That is called theory of computation, theoretical computations. So it is not a computer. It is not a. You cannot feel the machines yet. Touch and feel the machines. It is not a hard physical machine which you are solving the problems. It is a theoretical, it's a mathematical model. It's an abstract model where you can solve the problems mathematically. There is a notation is there, mathematical notation, mathematical steps you will be following to solve the problems. You have already idea, because previous topic in second unit and all, we discussed we are solving the regular expression problem, we are solving the DFA, NFA, NFA epsilon problems and all. We solved some of the classes you attended. You have an idea about the subjects. What we are doing with the subject actually here, we are solving the problems. What is the solution required here? Because see, you know now the some of the programs like the swapping of two values, factorial numbers, you know, because the logic already somebody found. You are not finding any new solution, new ideas for that programs under. That solution, how they derived? How they found the solution like this? Now your mouse is there. Using this mouse, you are giving the input. You have a keyboard, you have a compiler, you have what are components available, everything's invented by using a theory of computations only. Because this and all is a problem. It was a problem in the last 50 years, it was studied as a science, that is theoretical science. Then later, only 1936, Alan Turing invented all Turing machines, and then Chomsky norms are available. Chomsky classified the languages and all is there. So there are a lot of things are invented in 1950 this year only. So that is why this subject is very old subject, and that will be a core for the computer science. You understood or not? So theoretical computer science means it is to solve the problems. It is to solve the problems. It is a mathematical model. It's an abstract model which is used to solve the problem. You can understand what is mathematical model. I told you already in previous classes you listened. So now I'll tell you some of the example. For example, compiler design is there. The compiler design is one of the applications why it is application of theory of computation, what is happening in compiler, what is the use of the compiler? Someone can answer me. My voice is audible, no? Senbagam, Mallikannu, Muthu Sakti. Can you answer me? My voice is audible. If it is visible. Is it okay? You have to speak with me, then we have to, it is easy to understand the subject. PPT also visible. Very good. The use of compilers. Higher level language convert into lower level language. That is answer. What is the other purpose of the compiler? What is the use of the compiler? Tell me. See, just I give you small explanation on the theory of computation. Just it is a modeling. Modeling means what? So I have a problem like this. If you want to solve this problem, so two A should be accepted. Or I have a problem like this, int. So int is a keyword that need to be recognized. So like this, there are sometimes even numbers of A's and odd number of A's need to be recognized. A swapping of two values. Swapping of two values without temporary variable. That is one of the problem I want to solve. So like this, there are many problems are there. So these problems need to be solved. How we can solve? To solve this problem only, we are using this theory of computation. So like this, there are many problems are there. Not only this problem, you take it the banking sectors, you take it any other other sectors, right? Gaming section you take it, or any other analytical side you take it, whatever area you take it, everywhere there are a lot of problems are available. See, it's very simple example. You have a, you are writing the C program. When you study in the first year, while writing the C program, first step you will write the algorithm, then you will write the, then you will write the algorithm, then what you will write next step, what we can write, flowchart. That is flowchart you will draw. So like this, you will follow the steps. It is the steps to solve the problems. It is our one of the problem solving techniques only is called theory of computation. So algorithm means what? Step by step procedure to solve the problem. Step by step procedure. Understand the problems. We'll write first, take the inputs and process it and set the next output. That is algorithm. And flowchart means what? It is a pictorial representation of the particular problems. Why this is required? Still, I want to understand the problem clearly. Then I have to use this flowchart, you know. So algorithm, flowchart, then we'll write the coding. Finally, we are going for coding. Why? Because it is easy. Already I analyzed that my problem, what is the problem, what is the input I have to take, and what is the logic I have to use so that I can get the solutions. Everything I know. Why I'm following these steps? If I follow these steps only, I can understand how to solve this problem, how to code this particular problem. Everything I can understand. That is that kind of things only theory of computation only we are studying. Here also what we are doing, we have seen the, nowadays everything in our hand, we can easily understand. There is a computer is there, and before computer exist, before, now computers are available. Before computer there was a Turing machines. It was a computer before this computers. And one of the class I shown you this the Turing machine also. You also watched, when you joined only that time I shown you that Turing machines video also, right? So Turing machine, before the computer, Turing machine was there. What is the Turing machine we done? We just give the input. There is a read write head is there that will read the inputs. where it will be available, that inputs, it is in the infinite tape. That infinite tape is moving, moving to both the directions. From that, that will be read out. Then it will be processed. Finally, the output is coming. That output also written on the infinite tape only. So like this, here we have a models are there. There are so many abstract models are there. Using that model, we'll do this. Why I've told you this compiler, how your compiler is working. You know, compiler, in this compiler, what happened? There are two tasks, is main task for the compiler. One is the finding this index error. Finding this index error. Is there any invalid syntax, or is there any not used proper syntax? Then it will show you error. So there is a syntax problem. Instead of in the place of int, if you are missing this IT, then it is a syntax problem. And for loop, is there while loop, is there? There are many keywords are there. That is under syntax. And second thing is, it is allocating the memory. It is allocating the memory. If it is, if you are, for example, you declare a variable int equal to int A or float B like this, then what happened? This, what happened? Then this 2 bytes of memory will be allocated. 2 bytes of memory will be allocated. So like this one. So it is two things are done. So this is one of the program. How this compiler is designed because of the theory of computation. You will be studying Pustone Automata. In the Pustone Automata, you will be verifying this context-free language. That context-free language, while studying this context-free language, you can understand how this recent high-level language and all invented. How this particular language was developed. Java, other languages, how it was developed. Because you have to understand this compiler design and how the computer scientists were. How to develop this like compiler design programs or like this Java program like this, because of this core concept is available in theory of computation. What is grammar? What is languages? How this is verified in the mathematical model? Everything you will be put it in the theoretical model. Then you can understand this, what should be in the real model. That is your real, that is in real implementation. That is what you have to understand. So that is the purpose of this theory of computation. Software engineering you studied, you will be going for prototyping before implementation. You will be getting the requirements analysis and design, and finally you are going for coding. See, it is all why we have to do, so that we have to reduce the cost. Instead of going for this, just a minute. That is why. So what I'm telling this, you have to understand what is theory of computation. What is the importance of this subject to solve problem? That's a very simple word you can keep here. Theory of computation means solve the problem. There are discrete inputs. Using that inputs, you will be processing that particular inputs. Then you'll be getting the solution. That is output. That is also discrete outputs. So that is theory of computation. So for example, here I'm going to give you some example to understand this. For example, int is the what need to be recognized by the computer. How we can do, here we do the modeling. So that is, this is one of the state, that is key 0. So from there you have to go key 1. Because already you know the some of the concept, already you attended so many classes. You might be knowing this, what is theory of computation. Anyway, I will give you some basic introduction on this. So the next you see this. It is N. When you read the end, it is the final state. Final state always, you know, this is the double circle. So when it is T. So now you see, look at this one. So key 0 is one of the state. What is the state? What is the meaning of the state? State to remember the current input. It is to remember the current input. So key 0 is the state in which I am giving the input symbol I. So when it is read the I, it is right word, because I want to make a model to recognize this int keyword. The int keyword, because you understood the computer, whatever you are typing, everything need to be recognized by the computer. That is what the problem. So that problem solved inside the computer, it is solved, and then it was produced as a component here. So now you see, I is a word need to be recognized. Once it is recognized, it is going to next state. In this state, I am giving the another letter. It is N. It is N. Once N is recognized, N state. So it is going to final state. So when it is reaching to the final state, then that is a valid keyword. That keyword is accepted. That is the use of the recombination. You want to verify language accept not accepted. If should be accepted means what should be there? You should have a proper logic. So you have to find out the logic. Sometimes a number of days, then you have to find out the logic. Sometimes you have to see that there's a symbol from the right side, it should be 1 or 0. So that is all like this. So that is a kind of guys computation you are studying here. Computation means what? Calculation. So this is a theory of computation. So this modeling only is a theory of computation. You understand? So theory of computation is to solve the problem. That's all. So so let us discuss the topic one, that is introduction to formal proof. And what we discussed so far, what is the introduction to the theory of computation, what is the importance of this subject, and this and that we discussed. And also you have to understand the syllabus. We have 5 units. The first unit what we'll study, this is final automata, introduction to automata. And before discussing this first unit, you have to understand this subject, how this subject is syllabus is framed here. See, this way, theory of computation, there are different fields are available. Here we have this is a complexity. There are the different branches are available. Complexity theory is there, and automata theory is there. What we are going to study here, this is automata theory, formal languages and automata. You have to understand this formal language means what, and then you have to understand automata means what. So formal languages, you know this, we can say example, your C languages, C++, Java and all is it is derived from the formal languages. Already you know this regular language, regular expression and all we discussed. That regular language will verify in the finite automata. Here you have to understand formal languages. I can say example for formal languages, regular language. And another point I am talking about a finite automata. That automata is a mathematical model where I can verify that regular language is verified or not verified. That is the use of these formal languages and automata. This is a subject area. This is a major field in computer science to understand this, to understand and solve the problems. So that is why the particular 5 units what we are going to study here, formal languages and automata. Formal languages, you can understand this, there will be a regular language, there will be a context free languages, there is a recursively enumerable languages, recursive language. So like this languages are available. It's one side. Another side we'll study abstract machines, that is mathematical model. First one is finite automata, in which we have 3 categories: deterministic finite automata we'll study, non-deterministic finite automata, and then non-deterministic finite automata with the epsilon moves. Then we'll study Poisson automata. Then we'll study Turing machines. So like this, there is a mathematical models. So one side there is a mathematical model that will verify that languages. For example, language means what? So Tamil is a language. English is a language. To speak language, you should know grammar. So grammar means set of rules. For example, in English, you have a grammar. So present tense, past tense, future tense, like this, grammars are available. If you know grammar, then you can speak proper good English. The sentences and all you have to properly follow, then you can speak. And it is very important you have to follow the proper grammar, then you will get the language. Like this year also, there is a grammar. Based on the grammar, you will be constructing the language. That language can be verified in the finite automata. The very simple principle you can understand. The subject is like this only. The entire subject, what we are studying here, we have a formal language, that formal language will verify in the automata. Here automata is different types of automata are available. Finite automata, Poisson automata, Turing machines. These are the automata. Don't think that it is a machine. It is not a machine. You cannot touch and feel that machines. It is a mathematical model. Whatever you want to solve, you will be solving that problem using mathematical notations. So that is a modeling. You can MATLAB is a modeling tool, simulation tool. Like this, there are many tools are there. In our subject, we study in our syllabus, you can name this one, OOD. Rational rows you are using. That is also simulation tool only. You can do design after this design. That design you can convert into coding. Forward engineering. And there is a reverse engineering. So everything you need to follow some model. Modeling. Simulation. Try to understand what I'm talking here. So it is very much important to solve the problems. Why? Because we have to go like this to reduce the cost. See, something you are thinking, some problem you want to solve in the society, you cannot straight away go and implement that product. You cannot do like this. You have to analyze. You should do analyze the problem. You have to collect the requirements. That should be analyzed many times. Then find a proper logic to give the solutions. Further, Tandal, this is one of the problem solving techniques. Problem solving techniques, there are many things are available. It is one of the problem solving techniques. You understand? So I'll show you the syllabus and subject textbook also I'll discuss now. Then we'll start this unit, right? So far it is clear what is the introduction I do given to the subject. So far any doubt on this subject? Everybody understood that subject? What is the nature of the subject? What is theory of computation? Very simply, you can understand theory of computation means to solve the problems. To solve the problem. Look at the syllabus. Look at the syllabus. CS 8501. It's a subject code, theory of computation. The object is, you know, understand the language hierarchy, to construct the automata, to design context-free grammar, to understand Turing machines, to understand unpredictable problem, solvable, unsolvable problem we have to study. The first unit what we'll study, unit 1, automata fundamentals. So what I'm telling here, you'll be this, you can categorize this subject. There are two major areas. One is formal language, another one is automata. You will be studying these two topics only in the entire 5 units. One side you have to study formal language, another side you have to do verifications. That is automata. These two is the major topic in the subject. For that, the first unit, unit 1, automata fundamentals. So in this automata fundamentals, there is a prerequisites topic. That is introduction to formal proof. Introduction to formal proof. Additional form of proofs. Induction proofs. This already you studied in discrete mathematics. These subjects, these topics are all available. Inductive proofs and reduction proofs and all you studied. That is only for our subject. You also already will be studying the mathematics itself. That is for our support. It's a support for to understand for understanding this regular. Theory of computations, the proof, because everything here also we'll discuss some of the proof. This is the first topic also we are going to discuss next time. So that is the first topic, is a mathematical notation we have to understand. Then we'll start right away the subject, finite automata. So here you see finite automata, deterministic finite automata, non-deterministic finite automata, finite automata with the epsilon moves. This is the first unit. So here automata, you know already. What is automata? It is a mathematical model, abstract model to verify the language. Which language? That is regular language. We'll study in the second unit, regular expression, regular languages. And pumping lemma we'll study. Last class we discussed pumping lemma and all. And closure properties and all we discuss, right? And equivalence of minimization of automata we are going to study. Still we are not started. Up to closure of properties of regular language we discussed so far. For all 4 colleges, we stopped here, closer of regular language. Only one topic is available in second unit, equivalence and minimization of automata. we'll start next regular classes, right? So what we discuss here the language, regular expression, from that we have got the regular language. That language will verify in the finite automata. So previously we studied what is automata, how languages are accepted. These two topics are very related, interconnected. Then what is this? A major part we have to discuss: equivalence and minimization of automata. So automata equivalence means what? You can convert DFA to NFA, NFA to NFA epsilon, like this. And minimization, sometimes you have a complex design in DFA. You have 25 states or 30 states to states are used for the design. That can be converted into small DFA, small number of states. That is called minimization. So this is the second unit we'll study. This is very major topic to solve the problem. Major problems you have to solve. Yes. So these two units you can understand. So first unit automata fundamentals, second unit regular expression languages. Why I'm explaining this syllabus? You try to understand the summary of the subjects, what we are going to study in the subjects. If you have a clear idea on this subject while studying in the class, while discussing in the class, it will be very easy, right? Next, context-free grammar and languages. So here also what I'm talking here. So one side languages. So that is we have to see languages here. Context-free grammar. From this grammar will generate the language. That language will verify in the Pustone automata. This is the third unit. So here we will use another language, context-free language, and we use different type of Pustone automata. And next, the same the context-free languages we will study here: pumping lemma, normal forms, closure properties. Then we will study Turing machines. That Turing machine using the recursively enumerable languages, recursive languages, where we will verify this machine. Then finally, we have a divided into problems. One is the solvable, unsolvable, NP, polynomial in time. That is non-polynomial term and polynomial term. So like this, we'll study the category of the problem and we study post-correspondent problem like this. So these, you look at the five units. In the five units, you can simply understand there is a language, there is an automata. That's all. Simply you can understand. You say you have to language just study. No, other language only you have to verify in the automata. These two only you are discussing here. So very simple, but sometimes you may think that the subject problems are there, something mathematical notations are there. It will be somewhat difficult to understand. There is no worries like this here. Once you understand the subject of the nature of the subject and how to solve problems, one or two problem when you practice, then you can get interest. You can easily solve all the problems. Very simple. We can have a logic where there are problems are available for the problem, you are finding the solution mathematically. So very simple only. It is not a tough subject, but it is very important subject for your GATE. GATE and all, you have to study this subject only. GATE exam. There are so many competitive exams are there in the computer science field. For all the subjects, all the competitive exam, this is one of the important subject. You just go through in the Google theory of computations, the questions. You can get so many GATE questions. So I also taken so many questions in the iExplore, iLearn and all. Some of the GATE questions and all I included. So that is very important because this subject importance you have to understand. Most of the questions are coming from this theory of computations only. Because this is a subject, from this subject only computer design was there, derived, and then using in operating system, pattern matching, web technology subjects. So many subjects, because of this subject is very important. From this subject only, that subject and all derived. So that is why I'm telling the major questions coming from the competitive exams and theory of computation only. Regular languages, context-free languages, Turing machines. So that is why you have to give importance to the subjects. You can ask your seniors, they will tell this the nature of the subject, what is the difficulty in the subjects, everything that you can discuss with the seniors. But they understand this importance of the subject. So you have to give more importance on the subject. While studying the subject, what is the ultimate outcome? You will get the outcome from this subject. It will be improving this your logical thinking. Because as a computer science students, what you are going to do in the industry, you will be solving the problem. You are supporting the industry by solving the problems only. So how they select, the industry will select the people or the students who will give a solution quickly, who is thinking quickly, or you can say this. Quick learner, quick thinking, who is giving the solution quickly, that kind of candidates only they will select. That is why you will be asked to practice many problems. Find a solution quickly. So when you practice like this, then you can easy to solve the problems. That is why very important. This is one of the subject will improve your logical thinking. Will improve your problem solving skills. So that is why you have to study the subject and practice when you get the problem, because there are different problems also available. It is all given in the theoretical form. You understand this theoretically, what the explanation is given from that. You have to take the languages, then you have to verify. There are some challenges will come in this subject that will help you to understand how to solve the problems. So that is why this subject is very important. Understanding the fundamental of basics of this automata is very important. Construct automata, regular expression for any pattern, write the context-free grammar for any construct, design Turing machines for any languages. Turing machine is a last machine which exists before computers. There we only have functionality, that is addition of two numbers, multiplication, subtraction, and all we done this Turing machine only. That you can understand when we study this particular unit. And purpose of propose the computation solution using the Turing machines, tell you whether the problem is decidable or not. So these are the outcome of these subjects. When you learn this 5 units, you will get this knowledge, right? And what is the subject textbook? This is a book already I downloaded. One of your students I sent already these materials. Like this, there are many books are available. J. Hopcroft, Motwani, and J.D. Ullman. Introduction to Automata Theory, Languages, Computations. Second edition, Pearson Education 2003. It is available in the net e-books, in the form of e-books that you can download and keep in your system itself. Just copy these particular, just copy it and put it in the Google, right? And plus PDF, just put plus PDF, you'll get the books, you'll get these books. Mostly, all 5 units are covered in this books only. Because here, one or two problems are not solved properly. Properly in the sense, there will not be followed any steps. But the logic is given. What is the solution for that problem? It is given. It is explained in the theoretical manner. But you cannot find more steps on this problem. So that is my next book you can refer. J. Martin books and Sipser. This book you can get steps. And how the problem to be solved, the steps you can find from these books. J. Martin also available e-books. This next also, this book also, all books are available in e-books itself. In the form of e-books, all 4 books are available. I download all 4 books. I'll find out the difference of this problem solved in these books and these books. Just go through one glance, you can understand. You see this, the same finite automata, in the index by page you see, and go to the particular page and see that how the problems are solved. Same thing, check with J. Martin. Same thing. In the verification method, something differently used here. Here may be used extended, here may be used VDAS function. That's only the difference. Other than that, the same solution is available for the same problem. So these books are all, you just keep remember. What is a subject book for the theory of computation? J.D. Ullman book, Pearson Education. So that book you have to follow. It is your textbook. You just download it. Maximum problems for your university exam and all, the exact problem and these questions are coming from this exercise problem only. That is why I have given the PPT itself. Most of the exercise problem I have taken from this theory of computation books, J.D. Ullman book only, because questions are repeated from there only, and that only I have given the questions also. Big questions and all, I'll take from this book only. So you just look at the exercise part and university questions you take and compare. Most of the questions coming from this theory of computation, J.D. Ullman book only. And same problem also solved in other references books also. And that all you can understand. The problem is solved in the problem, J. Martin book. I'll narrate steps use for Nirpanga so that we easy understand. In the book, for the RN, this and foreign other books only. Problems are solved some theoretically solution. So you 2 or 3 times read one more than you can understand that problem. So this is about our textbooks. This is about our textbooks. So understand what is your subject code? CS8501 Theory of Computation. What is the textbook name? J. Hopcroft, Motwani, J.D. Ullman. J. Jerry Ullman book, there are many books are available. Even web technology book also available. There are many books he written. These authors. So this automata theory, it is one of the books you have to follow. Another two books, same Martin Sipser books you can follow, Michael Sipser. This is our syllabus. So first unit, we'll start the first topic, introduction to formal proof. And then we have to start second topic, finite automata. In your e-box login, we have two modules. One module is introduction to formal proofs. Another module is finite automata. There are two modules available. I'll be enabling that model for your practice. The practice session, you have to practice the iLearn, iExplore, iAnalyze, iDesign, and iAssess model. So there are five models available. I explore and I learn. I give 20 questions. When you learn, when you solve that problems, when you solve these questions, then you can easily understand the basics. I've given the years and authors who invented most of the questions, the basic fundamental questions I asked in the I learn, I explore in model one and model two also. When you solve this I learn and I explore, you can easily understand the subject. And there is a review section also there. If you're not given the wrong answer, you just click the review answer. You can get the right answer, which is the right answer. So using that answer, you have to understand the subject. Don't simply click that answer and don't do it simply. When you give the answer, you have to understand the what is the answer for particular questions. What is the question is asked? What is the answer? That you have to understand. That will help you to understand the entire subjects. So that is why I'm telling this. This I learn, I explore. You have to carefully, you have to solve. I analyze, I given some more big questions, some big problems I've given. It is all in the MCQ types only. You can easily answer that questions also. There is no review section. And I assess timing will be set. Within that time frame, you have to solve the problems. You just practice it. I assess. I design somewhat complex, then I analyze that you have to solve. So everywhere the different problems only. Whatever you solve in the I analyze, you cannot find in the I design. I design something different problem, which different person I taken. ISS also I have taken a different problems which not studied previously. Like this only all the models I followed. So it is all you have to practice. This is very important for your preparation of university exam or any assessment you are going to do. Before you have to practice all these five models of all five categories, then it will be easy. It's a very good platform. It's a digitalized platform to learn things properly and clearly. So this is one of the best practices we are following. So keep interest, create interest and do like this only. So that is why I'm asking the student, once class is over, immediately go for practice. And while practicing some of the questions you have a doubt and something you want to study little, means you can go to the books. Already you have a download of the books. The particular topic you go and take, go and see the books itself. You can understand. Otherwise you can go to my PPT. For some of the questions I have taken from the PPT itself, because I have given explanation the same questions I want to test you. I framed the questions. So you can take this PPT or the textbook to refer and understand the questions given in the platform itself, eBox platform itself. So this is what you have to do, the regular practice. So I want to give you introduction to the subject, and then I want to give you this sub-syllabus introduction. Then I want to give you this eBox platform. So I completed all three area. So you have to follow regularly. So by next year you are starting the second. Already you joined with us 3-4 classes. And next topic and all, regular class, we will start the equivalence and minimization automata. And we'll solve this. There are 3-4 up to Friday you have a classes. Saturday you have a classes. So within this class hours, we can cover this first unit. And if you have a doubt, you can call me, you can ask me immediately. Otherwise, you can type it in the chat window. So for any doubt is there, whatever doubt is coming, just type it in the chat window if you are not able to ask me. If you are asking me, it is good. You can talk to me, you have to ask me immediately and stop it. So wherever the doubts are there, you can stop it and discuss with me, because it's a problem solving. We together need to solve the problems. It's not like this one way of speaking here. You also join with me and solve the problems. Right? So all are ready. Let us start the first topic. So far, whatever I taught you, whatever we discussed so far in the session, do you have doubt on this topic? Very good. Vallikunnu and Sembagam both given some answer for the compiler design. What about others? Sembagam, already you guys send me mail and then I share materials also for you. And others also typing here. Vallikunnu, very good. Muthusakthi. What about others? Others are joined properly and listening to me. So don't waste your time. It is a right time to learn this subject. Just 1 hour. You're learning this subject. You should listen to the subject. It's a very important subject. And post subject. That is why I'm telling. When you listen and when the subject only, you can easily understand. You cannot study. You can study, but the basic things you have to understand. So that is why I'm asking everybody, listen carefully the subjects. So let us start with start the subject quickly. So I given this introduction. That introduction will help you to understand the subject quickly. So now we will start the. Subject. So introduction to formal proof. It's the first topic. I shown you in the units syllabus itself. This is the first topic you have to understand. Why this subject? This topic is required. Why we have to study this topic? Because to understand the mathematical notations, the step by step statements to prove the problems, to prove that particular statement is true. So that and all we have to understand. These are basics. We have to study this mathematical side so that the finite automata and other automata, when you study, when you solve the problems and theorems, it is very easy. That is why. The first topic is a mathematical topic to understand. So here, what are the contents we are going to discuss? Introduction to theory of computation, almost over. We discussed so far the introduction to theory of computations only. The next topic, introduction to formal proof, you have to discuss. Additional form of proof, you have to discuss. Inductive proofs, you have to study. In this topic, the major topic, what we have to understand, inductive proof. Another one is reduction proof. These two topics, very important. You will be getting questions mostly from this inductive proof. And regressive reduction proof. These two proofs are very important. You have to understand. Then I given you introduction about the theory of computation. It's a mathematical model which computes an algorithm in a step-by-step manner. So, theory of computation means what? Solving the problem. So, like y equal to f and x of x, function of x. So, x is input. There is operations. There will be some function performed. Then it is giving the output. So that is the kind of nature of theory of computation, in which we are giving the inputs. X is the input, which gives to the computing system with the computation function. Then output is received as a Y. This is the nature of the subjects. So what happened here? Your machine is there. Your abstract machine is there. There, in which we are giving the input, that will be processed in the automata. Then we will get the output. That is the introduction to the subject, theory of computation, TOC, basic idea, modeling of computing that we discussed. Computation means execution of algorithm, you know already. Computation is a sequence of steps that can be performed by computers. So here, anything you want to solve, you have to follow some sequence of steps. Even mathematics, when you solve the problem, what you will be doing in the rules, and then you give in the formula itself, substitute in the formula itself, then you are finding the solution. same steps you have to follow in the theory of computation also. We'll be taking the inputs, and that will be used in the model itself. We'll do the computation, then finally we can get the output. That is what you have to follow. So DBOCs are just abstract model of computation represented mathematically. So how we are connected with mathematically with respect to mathematics, it is used most of the notations from here only. So you have to learn that mathematical notations properly. And there are symbols, different kind of symbols we'll be using, mathematical symbols. That also you have to understand, and the meaning of the symbols also very important, so that it is easy to understand the subject. And your computer which perform computation are not actual computers. That is what I told you already. Not missing to touch and feel. It is a mathematical model. It is a mathematical concepts. They are abstract machines, so that is what you have to understand. Example, Turing machines, there is a universal model. Finite atomic, there is a restricted model. So these two we can understand. An application of the theory of the computations, language design, compiler design, robotics, artificial intelligence, knowledge engineering. These are the application where the theory of computation concepts are used. Language design, compiler design, and language design in the sense you have C++, and then you have React.js, and then there are Ruby on Rails. There are many languages in the computer science field. So how these languages are done, how the languages are designed and developed because of this core concept, this formal languages. So that is why this is applications of the complication DOC. Compiler design, Java C is there. In C++ compiler, Turbo C compiler is also available. There are compilers are available, which are all programs recognize the particular say statements in the program statements. That is the purpose of this compilers program center. And robotics field, there are robotics concepts. Whatever is there in the field, everything is developed using the models only, mathematical model. Artificial intelligence. Now our platform also AI-driven models. Artificial intelligence, whatever the human beings doing, that will be converted into automation. IoT, Internet of Things, there are concept IoT, you know that, Internet of Things. What is meaning of Internet of Things? The softwares and then components, even electronic devices, using combination of the software and then some of the hardware components, controlling some of the functionalities. Energy meters is one of the IoT products. Energy meters, it will be calculating and putting into the analytics part. It is calculating and predicting what is the cost will be there in the next month. What is the cost for the other 2 months? Everything you can do predictions. IoT, you can use it. So IoT is a very important field. You can easily understand everywhere. Even agri automation is there. Agri, whatever the manual work is there, that we can control it using the automation tools. There is even some example I can understand. Water flow. If water is overwhelming, then immediately there is indications coming to you. That is another product, IoT products. IoT product, you can easily understand whatever. Everything is required nowadays. Even Internet of Things is very important. And knowledge engineering, analysis. Everything is application of the TOs. So any field you take without theory of computation, there is no field. So that is why theory of computation is very important. How we can understand from this particular subject, how we have to solve the problems step by step. How we can find out the unique solutions for that particular problems. Everything you can understand from TOC only. To understand the subject, some of the basics you have to study properly. That is what this formal proof and what is alphabet, string, operations, properties, languages, notations, and what are the operations performed on this. Grammars means what? Graphs, trees. These are verification of the languages. For this small concepts and all, you have to study. Now, the topic formal reduction to definition, other theorem forms, if and only if, theorem not in if, then statements. These are the formal proof you have to study. What is formal proof? Step-by-step statements to prove that statement is true. A sequence of statements to prove that the first statement is true. That is a formal proof. Formal proof means what? Proof means what? You just prove it. If something you are talking about, something you want to tell. This is what I've done. then you have to prove this. This is what is happening here in this situation. Something you need a proof. The particular proof you want to prove, you need a proof for a particular statement. Then you will have to take the sequence of statements to prove that it has happened or it has not happened. Like this only. You know, you can think so many situation like this. When you discuss in the reduction proof, we can understand why this is required like this one. So, reduction proof, reduction proofs, and then induction proof. This and all you have to study here. So, as a formal proof, this proof why it is required to understand how to solve the problem. So, we have to follow the steps. How many steps? We have to follow the steps to solve the problem. You have to follow the steps to prove that the statement is true, because you have given the particular statement. Whether the statement is true or not, we'll follow other statement to come. We will conclude that what is the first statement is given is true. So that is the purpose of this formal proof. An additional form of proofs also we'll study, and finally induction proof. Study here. Formal proof. Formal proof are a derivation of a finite sequence of sentences. Each is an axiom followed by rules of finite sequence of sentences. Finite sequence of sentences are a set of sentences to prove the statement is true. So that is the idea of this formal proof. Your major two types: deductive proof, induction proof. This deductive proof is very important. Here we use the two statement. One is the initial statement. Another one is conclusion statements. These two are very important. These two are very important. You understand? There are two categories: deductive proof and then inductive proof. You understand? Now we'll discuss deductive proof. Hypothesis means what? Hypothesis means it is a initial statement. The first statement is true. Then you have to prove that conclusions. Second statement also true. From using the second statement, the second statement is given. Using the second statement, you can prove that first statement is true. That is called deductive proof. So the second statement is deducted from the first statement. You understand here? Look at the statement given here. Deductive proof consists of sequence of statements where true values leads to the initial statement called hypothesis to a conclusion statement. Hypothesis means first assumptions. For example, A greater than 6. That is a condition. I want to prove that the first statement is true. For that, I have to use the second statement. For example, I can tell you like this. Deduction proof means what? Hypothesis. Some statement I given like this. Today I have taken a theory of computation class. I started at 8:30. This is a statement I given. To prove that first statement what I given, it is true, then I have to take the conclusion statement. What is the conclusion statement? I can take this recorded video. It is happening this present time. What is the time now? This time I can mention this was a topic I spoken. So using this statement, using this particular time, what is the topic I discussed, using this particular statement, I can prove this statement. I have started my class 8:30, that video competition classes, that I can prove this first statement is also true. Like this, any scenario you take it. So any situation you take it, the first statement you given, that first statement is true means, based on the second statement, third statement, you have to prove that first statement is true. That is called deductive proof. The second statement is deducted from the first statements. That is the idea of this deductive proof. It is a mathematical idea. You studied this one in discrete mathematics also. In discrete mathematics, you studied this topic. What is deductive proof? What is inductive proof? In this inductive proof, you might be solved many problems. So here, try to understand deductive proof consists of sequence of statements where a true values leads to the initial statements called hypothesis, to a conclusion statement. Here you may have a question like this. What is hypothesis? Hypothesis is one of the assumptions. You have an initial statement. Initial statement is called hypothesis, some assumptions. That assumption is true. How I can prove that first statement is true? Based on the second statement. That is called deductive proof. We'll take one of the example here. Hypothesis tends to conclusions. If there's a statement A greater than 6, then C is true. If you prove that A, the first statement is true, then second statement is true. Look at this one. Look at this example. if x greater than equal to 4, then 2 power x greater than equal to x power 2. This statement is similar to if h then c format. Here you see this one. Look at this one. How to solve this one using the hypothesis, using this reduction proof? The first topic for our understanding only. It is to understand this mathematical proof only. Then second topic is a very important topic we'll have to study. For that, this topic is much useful to understand. Now this is not a tough one only. So first statement I given. Now in the first statement, I have to prove that. So what is the first statement I given is true. எப்படி நான் ப்ரூவ் பண்ணனும்னா செகண்ட் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் ஃப்ரம் தி செகண்ட் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் ஐ கேன் ப்ரூவ் தட் செவன் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் இஸ் ட்ரூ சோ ஹியர் யூ see this x greater than equal to 4 மீனிங் என்ன இனி எடுத்துக்கிற வேல்யூஸ் வந்து x ங்கற வேல்யூஸ் எடுத்துக்கறீங்க தட் வேல்யூஸ் இஸ் greater than equal to 4 ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் இப்ப என்ன வேல்யூஸ் எடுத்துக்கலாம் equal to 4 மீன்ஸ் 4 எடுத்துக்கலாம் 5 எடுத்துக்கலாம் 6 எடுத்துக்கலாம் சோ யூ ஹேவ் டு டேக் தி வேல்யூஸ் ஃப்ரம் 4 5 6 only சோ தட் வேல்யூஸ் Then put it, substitute this x here. X 4 is the dina, 2 power x greater than equal to x power 2. Apo, if you this condition is true, 4 equal greater than equal to 4, this condition is true. Then I have to check this statement. 2 power x, what is the value here? 2 power 4 greater than equal to x power 4. Sorry, 4 power 2. 4 power 2 is what is the meaning? 16. Then here you take 2 power 4 means that is also 16 only. But these both are equal. So this statement is true, then this statement also true. This is similar to H then C format. So H is true for x equal to 6 or x equal to 4. H is false. If x equal to 2, you cannot take. This is false. Then this is also false. If x equal to 2, when you substitute here x equal to 2, this is also false. But when it is true, when first statement is true, then second statement is true. First is true, you have to prove. Then you have to prove the second statement also true. So what is the first statement? It is called hypothesis, initial statement. The first statement is called initial statement. That is hypothesis. Hypothesis means assumption. I have assumption. I have assumption like this. You can take any other scenario. Any other scenario, right? So second statement is conclusion statement. Conclusion, yes, first statement is true. So that is why I implies H C, or H tends to C, right? H holds C. So there are different forms. That is why H is true for 6, H is false for X equal to 2. Example 2, if X and sum of the square for 4 positive integers, then 2 power X greater than equal to X power 2. So this is about the reduction proof. Understand? The first topic, we have a two subtopics. One is the induction proof. Another one is reduction proof. These two topics you have to listen because your 2 marks are asked from here only. So you will get 2 marks from these topics. And from the induction problem, you will get some questions, right? Reduction to definition. There is a big problem. Is a large problem that you are not able to understand. You are not able to solve means. That problem you can convert into hypothesis statements and conclusion statements. So many hypothesis, so many conclusion statements, so that you can prove it easily. That is called reduction to definitions. If you're not sure how to start a proof, then convert all the terms as a hypothesis to the definition. So that is the idea of this reduction to definitions. If you are not able to solve this problem, try to prove that problem, then you have to reduce into hypothesis and conclusion statements. So many hypothesis, conclusion statement. Then you can easily understand this reduction to definitions. Another theorem forms. If then, you know already you study C statement, C languages. There is if statement. If A greater than B, then there is a printf statement. Or something. Sometime you studied if then if else statement. If condition is true, then it will be done. Else other statement will be printed. Then else if later you studied nested if studied. So like this, that and all you just from you studied from this mathematical notation only. It is also told in some other form. If H, then C. the same say equivalent statement for if H then C. H implies C. H only if C. C if H. All are same equivalent statement only. Whenever H holds, holds C follows. Or if H holds, then C follows. So everything the same meaning only. All the three statement is same meaning only. If it is true, then the second the statement is given. If it is false, the other statement will be given. So like this, the other theorem forms also there. You are familiar with these statements. This if and only if. This is a very important notation we'll use in our entire 5 units. Wherever the theorems are available, there we'll use if statement. If IFF, 2F will be given. That is, if and only if. So far you studied if statement, else if statement, nested if. This is the one new statement you have to study. If and only if. So what is the meaning of this if and only if? A if B means A is equivalent to B. A exactly when B means if X, if let us consider X is the element which is available in A. The same element also available in B. So if X is available in A, if and only X is available in B. That is the idea of this A if and only if B. You try to understand the scenario. ஒரு எலமெண்ட் வந்து எக்ஸ்ங்கிற எலமெண்ட் எடுத்துட்டு நம்ம ஏங்கிற செட்ல செக் பண்றோம். இந்த பர்டிகுலர் செட் எக்ஸ் இஸ் அவைலபிள். அப்ப எக்ஸ் இஸ் அவைலபிள் இந்த பர்டிகுலர் செட்னா இஃப் அண்ட் ஒன்லி தட் எக்ஸ் இஸ் அவைலபிள் இன் பி. அப்படி அவைலபிளா இருந்தா தான் ஏ இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு பி, இல்லைனா ஏ இஸ் நாட் ஈக்குவல் டு பி. தட் இஸ் அ மீனிங் ஆஃப் இஃப் அண்ட் ஒன்லி இஃப். ட்ரை டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட். இந்த இஃப் ஐ டபுள்எஃப் போட்டிருந்தாவே எங்கேயாவது யூஸ் பண்ணியிருந்தாங்க அப்படின்னா தீரத்தில் இதுதான். யூ ஜஸ்ட் கீப் இன் யுவர் மைண்ட். Oh, you'll be whatever you take it one side, the same will be taken on the other side. Both are equal, if and only if. If X is available in one set, the same available in the other set also. If it is available in both sides, then it is our equivalent. Additional form of proofs. Additional form of proofs. Listen, so far we discussed so far. Proof. What is proof? Step-by-step statements are sequence of statement to prove the statement is true. That is called proof. Why we have to study the first topic like this? Because the same kind of topics will be used in the further units. That is why you have to study this kind of mathematical proof or this mathematical notations. Additional form of proof. Already reduction proof we studied. Reduction proof la hypothesis and conclusion. I have asked many questions in I explore I learn side. Hypothesis using this conclusion statement, many questions are asked. You read out the question carefully and answer this. Hypothesis means initial statement and C is conclusion statement. What is reduction proof? Reduction proof, step by step statement to prove that first statement is true. Or it is deducted from the first statement. Something you given like this in your I learn and I explore sessions. There are many MCQ questions, multiple choice questions. And proof by contrast metrics, contra positives, and proof by contradiction, proof by counter examples. These are the things you have to discuss. And proof by sets. Here we use if and only if statements. IFF. If A and F are two expressions represent the sets, then the statement E equal to F means two sets are represented same. Two sets are equal. The set, you know that A equal to open and close braces. Instead, we write 1, 2. Right? Listen. Now we will discuss. This is a particular set. Some basics I want to give you. I look at here. Here you see this E equal to E one of the set and F another set. The E set means what? Collection of elements, collection of data items, 1, 2, 3. Here also F means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like this you are having. So here you see this E set is one is available, F also one is available. So the element, we take one sample example, let us take X equal to 1, which is available in E side. And also when you take the same X, and when you check in the F side, it is also available. So if and only if X is available in E, also it is only if X is available in F. So both are equal. So equal, that is called proof by sets. Set you already studied. Set means what? Set of elements. So listen, some more times are available only. So listen here, this is very important. Proof by sets. Consider two sets are available, A and B. A is having collection of elements, B is having collection of elements. You will check one of the elements is A, same elements available in B. That is proof of sets. By cumulative law of union of two sets, R is one of the expression, S is another expression. R union S equal to S union R. If R one of the set, S one of the sets combined together. And S union one of the set, R union of the set combined together. So elements are equal. So that is the idea of this E equal to F. And if you take like this, then that is also equal. That is proof by sets. And proof by contrast positive. If any statement is like if as then C, it should be written in contra positives. Contra positive means first statement we say H is true, then C also true. We take it in opposite manner. If not C, then not C. If it is not true, then it is not true. Like this. That is proof by contra positive. Next one is contradiction. Contradiction we'll consider in opposite manner. Other side. If H then C, H tends H implies C. If H not C implies falsehood. Right? What is the meaning of this contradiction? The first statement, it is a regular, the one we studied like this, regular language. A power n, P power n is not a regular. You have to prove using pumping lemma. We'll use the contradiction method. So using the contradiction method, it is not a regular means assumption. By assumption, I'll consider this is a regular. That is contradiction method. I given the first statement, it is not a regular. And second statement, what I've taken, by assumption, I'm taking this is a regular. Then I want to prove that the first this is true. It is a regular like this. I want to prove, but I cannot prove this. Why? Because it is. I know it is false. But I want to prove. I want to prove it. It is true. If I am not able to solve this as true, then it is false only. That is called contradiction method. Will you use this method in further section and all subsequent section and all? We'll study this contradiction method. We'll do like this only. Any pumping lemma concept you want to study, there and all we use contradiction method only. Contradiction, you know the meaning, contradict. Nama kudukra statement ku contradict manner. Edirmuraya, opposite manner la dhaan vandhu we'll take the assumptions. So when you take the assumption like this, we cannot prove this because the statement I know it is true only. So like this only it is in the proof of contradiction, right? Proof of counter example. I given a statements. I want to prove that statement it is true by using the counter examples. Edavar example vandu kandipa and the statement vandu true nu prove pannu. Andha maari statement I will analyze and find out. Adha vandu counter example appdi solluvom. All primes are odd numbers. Idha prove pandra edavar example eduthu na prove pannuven. There is no pair of integer a and b such that a mod b equal to b mod of a. Proof. One is the proof by sets. And second one is contrapositive. Contrapositive. Next one is contradiction. Last one is proof by counter example. So this is what we discuss. And final topic, introduction to proofs. So now we have time 10-12. Another 15 minutes time we can take. We'll cover the first topics. Because already you joined many classes. Don't insert me like this, taking this subject very slowly. You have already idea. I'm just covering the topic. I want to cover this topic so that it is easy for you. Right? I'm going the right way. You got to understand this topic because it's just simple topic only. Because our important topics start from second topic only. There only the problems are there. It is for understanding only. Understanding the mathematical notations only. So far what we discussed. Are you listening to me, students? Nobody sleeping? All are connected and watch, listening to me only now. Yes. Okay. So try to understand the concept which we cannot study again and again in the book itself. Yeah, same thing in the book also. So what we discussed so far, the topic, first topic, introduction to formal proof. Proof means meaning itself is there. Proof. You should have proof. Proof pannunga. அப்படி சொன்னோம் அப்படின்னா நம்ம சொன்ன ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் கரெக்டாக ப்ரூவ் பண்ணணும் சம் எவிடன்ஸ் சம்திங் சம் சிச்சுவேஷன் யூ ஆர் சீயிங் ஆர் எக்ஸ்பிளைனிங் டு சம்படி எல்ஸ் தட் பர்டிகுலர் சிச்சுவேஷன் தென் யூ ஹவ் டு ப்ரூவ் இட் யூ சம்திங் யூ ஆர் டெல்லிங் அபவுட் திஸ் இஸ் வாட் ஹேப்பன் சம்வேர் தென் யூ சுட் ஹவ் ப்ரூஃப் சம் எவிடன்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி டே லைக் திஸ் ஓன்லி ப்ரூஃப் வி வென் எவர் யூ ப்ரூவ் சம்திங் யூ வாண்ட் டு ப்ரூவ் ப்ரூஃப் அண்ட் ப்ரூவ் வாட் இஸ் திஸ் ப்ரூஃப் மீன்ஸ் சம் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் இஸ் கிவன் தட் யூ ஹவ் டு யூசிங் தி ப்ரூஃப் யூ ஹவ் டு ப்ரூவ் இட் The statement is true abin proof and the particular proof is given that is you have to use this as a setup statement to prove that the particular proof is true so like this only you are doing this subject so introduction to formal proof what we discussed first one is reduction proof now you keep remember one is hypothesis meaning enna assumption some assumption you have. The first statement la kuduthuringa அந்த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் ட்ரூன்னு யூஸ் எப்படி ப்ரூவ் பண்ண முடியும் யூஸ் இன் தி செகண்ட் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் அதனால தான் டிடக்ஷன் அப்படின்னா தி செகண்ட் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் வந்து டிடக்டட் ஃப்ரம் தி ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் தட் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் தட் இஸ் ரிடக்ஷன் ப்ரூஃப் யூஸ்வலாக இந்த ஃபார்மல் ப்ரூஃப் வந்து மேஜர் கேட்டகரி ரெண்டு தெர் ஆர் டூ கேட்டகரிஸ் சம் டூ மார்க்ஸ் யூ மே கெட் அண்ட் இன்டர்னல் டெஸ்ட் ஆல்சோ வில் ரைட் யூ வில் பி கெட்டிங் டெஃபினெட்லி ஒன் க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் தி இண்டக்ஷன் ப்ரூஃப் ஆர் ரிடக்ஷன் ப்ரூஃப் ரிடக்ஷன் ப்ரூஃப் யூ சீ ரிடக்ஷன் ப்ரூஃப் மீன்ஸ் வாட் The statement is hypothesis. The first statement is true. Hypothesis using the second statement conclusions. That is induction proof. The next one is induction proof. You have to study. And before studying this, additional form of proofs. There are additional form of proofs. What is the first proof? Proof by sets. And second one is contrapositives. And third one is contradiction method. And last one is proof by counters. These are the topics we discussed. And last topics. Problems. Same kind of problem you will study in the discrete mathematics. Might be you studied already this particular topics. Have you studied this topic? Solving using the induction principle. Can someone answer me? Induction principle already studied in discrete mathematics? Yes or no? Sanba, have you studied this topic previously? Yes. Anyway, I'll give some idea on this topic because already you studied this topic. What is induction principle, inductive principle, and compare with this deduction and induction. Deduction, we see we have a initial statement and then a conclusion statement. You can prove the statement is true. In induction, we'll take the iterative steps. We can take the iterative, rigorous steps to solve the problems. To prove that the statement is true, that is induction proof. Induction means you just keep remember there is a repetition. That is recursive steps. We follow the recursive steps, or you can say you can have induction principles. You can follow to solve the problem. What is induction principle? We'll use the smallest values to highest values to solve this particular statement is true. That is called induction principle. Initially, we take n equal to 0. We prove that LHS equal to RHS. Left hand side is given is true. That is also equal to right hand side. What is given? Both are true. That is induction principle. Initial values. Then we'll take the next values. N equal to 1. Then we'll try to prove that LHS also true. RHS also true. The next we'll take n equal to k. We substitute another constant values. Then either k we'll take in the place of n. We'll substitute k. Then we'll try to prove that it is true. Yes, if it is true, if n equal to k is true, then prove that n equal to k plus 1. When you take the next values, whether it is true in both the side, LHS and right RHS, it is called induction proofs. That is what is given here. If we prove S of I, then we prove that all n greater than equal to I. The next S of n equal to greater than equal to S of n plus 1. Then we conclude S of n for all n greater than equal to 1. It has two parts, basic parts, another one is induction part. Basic parts, we will substitute the values n equal to 0, n equal to 1. And induction part, we'll use n equal to k, then n equal to k plus 1. These are the steps you have to remember. If you already studied this, these are the topics. Yeah, these are the steps you have to follow. Induction steps, we assume n greater than equal to I, where I is the basics of integer. We have to show that if S of n, then S of n plus 1. So that steps you will have to supply in the problems to solve, right? Take one of the example here, one of the examples. Prove an induction method on n. I equal to 0 to n. I squared equal to n into n plus 1, 2n plus 1 divided by 6. We have to prove this using induction principle. So what we can do here, first if n equal to 0, when n equal to 0 means what happened? 0 this side. And we are put here n 0. 0 into multiplication of 0, in the other values everything 0. So LHS is equal to NHS. It is true only. You take n equal to 1. I equal to 1 means what? 1 power square 2, it is 1 only. If we substitute 1 here, 1, 1 plus 1, 2. Here you see this, 1 into 2 into 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 into 2, 6, 6 divided by 6, it is 1. So LHS 1, RHS 1, it is equal. The next we take the values, n equal to k. So in the place of n, you can take k plus 1, 2k plus 1 divided by 6. It is same only, both the side, k squared. It is n squared. So it is like this only. If you take n squared, this values, when you put k, k squared. So like this will be, you can take the next values like this. Induction principle, now you substitute. If you want to prove S of I, and we prove that for all n greater than equal to I, S of n plus 1, then you may conclude this for all n greater than equal to 1. What is the conclusion we have to take here? Both side it is true. That is what the principle. Put n equal to n plus 1 in the equation 1. What is the equation here? This is the equation. So in the case of n equal to n plus 1, you just substitute. N plus 1, n plus 2, 2n plus 1, divided by 6. What's the values? You just multiply. N plus 1 plus n into n squared, 3n plus 2. Here 2n plus 3 divided by 6. And expand this and x equations. You just multiply. 2n keep 3, 6n squared, 4n, 3n squared, 9. Just multiplication divided by 6. And same thing. And left hand side, you just verify. N Sn plus 1 means what? S of n plus S of n plus 5. So this now I know the values. N plus 1 squared I have to see. Look at here. This values and this values. Just add it together. Plus multiplying 6 on the numerator. You will get this values. You will see the equations. So this equation and this equation, see, both are same. Both are same. So S equal to N plus 1, also true. It is hence proved. It is called induction principle. Understand? RTP. It is not audible. Is there any lower bandwidth? Right. Now it's audible. Aarti, my voice is audible. Someone can speak with me, no? We're solving the problem. Next, we have to solve finite data meta problems. Kindly speak to me. It is not a tough one. You just speak with me in Tamil and English, not a problem. So English is very important. Whatever English is, we are not expecting any excellent English here. Whatever you're thinking, whatever keep in your mind, that you have to speak in English, convert in English. in understandable manner. That's enough. You have to speak computer science students for the interview purpose. If you are facing the interviews, when you speak only, they can understand what is the knowledge you have. And whatever you have, you have to speak and you have to explain to them. So that only it is easy. Don't be shy and don't get fear for speaking with anybody else. You have to speak. There is no other way. This is the platform you can interact with me. You are not showing your face. Just unmute your audio and then you speak to me. Nothing is problem here. Nobody is thinking about you or something. Just speak to me, right? You can get out your fears. That is very important. Try to understand. You will not feel that you are in the third year. When you face in the interview only, you just you will be feeling like this. You should have spoken before itself. Something you have a confidence, you can speak. That is very important. Then you will be facing the situation. After completing your degree, when you're going to the industry, you have to speak. And the time you should not feel. We are all experienced people. We are also same came through, so the same experience. We were also like this one time. We were a students and we faced like this problem. We know something, but we will not speak. The Marla situation, I also felt, you also felt. We are all coming from the rural background. We are not able to speak sometimes English. We know English, but sometimes we are not able to speak. There are different kind of people are available out of 21. Everyone, the different kind of nature. For everybody, for same practice, you have to speak in English. You have to solve the problem. Interviews with the confident. You have to have always a optimistic way, that is positive nature, confident, positivity. You have to think, given the pandemic time, the COVID-19, this situation, we think positively and we are moving towards something will happen positively for us. That positiveness create our impact in our life. Our career will be good. God will help us. So we have to work hard. Something we have to do daily. Today, if you're sitting inside in front of the computers, we have to do our work positively. There is a benefit for us. Help us for our career. We understand the students. Summa namas on the connect panitum. Simply sitting and wasting the time is not at all useful for you and for me also. Take it positive manner. In the title on the simply they're taking the class and wasting passing our time. So don't think like this. Everybody have a game, everybody have a goal. You have to work for your goal. You have ambitions, you have something target. For your target, you have to do work. You have to analyze yourself, find out your trap negatives that you have to overcome. Negative in the sense, sometimes we are not able to speak. There are merits out there. Somebody will solve the problem quickly. Somebody will not solve the problem quickly. Somebody will solve the problem quickly. Everybody has the practice. Another practice is always a matter. You have to practice quickly. So, computer science students, try to understand. The industry is good. You have so many opportunities. We know you can work from home. There are people, you can see the neighbors. So many are working from the home itself. They are developing the software. Everywhere you can see. So now the industry are getting the good production. The productivity is improved. Why? Because even this pandemic time and the COVID-19, they got a good production, productivity. In the English, productivity. Why? The same kind of works they are doing from the home itself. So as a you have to solve the problems. You have to learn software properly. So it is the right platform for us. You are learning everything freely. You can see. Yes, there are a lot of languages. If you learn it outside, much money. So the platform is very good platform. It's a digitalized platform. And it is artificial intelligence platform. You can learn it. We can easily evaluate you. There are very good platform because it is our fortunate. Right time you're getting this platform. So you take it, everything is positive manner. You have to attend the class regularly. And if you're sitting in front of the system, 1 hour means 1 hour you have to utilize it properly. See, out of 21 people, somebody listen carefully, somebody is not taking it properly. So that is what I'm asking. This is my request. It's now 10:28 time. Another 2 minutes is there. So for the first topic we completed, I've given you introduction. I've given you this, how you have to be. Prepare yourself. It's all very important because we are in the computer science field. I'm here for 14 years in the field. I have taken this theory of computation more than 5 times. Yeah, if I have taken this subject from 2008 syllabus itself, 2008 regulation itself I have taken many times, and then 13 regulation, 17 regulation, I know this syllabus. And this time syllabus is framed exactly. There is sometime before and all, the first unit itself is a vast syllabus. But now they are divided into properly. All 5 units equally, then they given a topics. The connectivity also is proper. So I know the all regulations, the topics. I have taken the subject many times. We have produced a result more than 85% in the subjects. So because of subject understanding only. So that is what my request, as by my experience, as a computer science students, you should be engineers, computer science engineer. For that, you have to solve the problem. So problem solving is very important for us, for a computer science engineer. So we are ideal. Nobody is watching us, monitoring us like this. Don't think that. You have to answer for your future in any assets. So based on the experience I'm telling, daily you have to be active. This day for you, this time you have to practice. So after this session, you have a practice session is there. In the practice session, this I already this will be visible. This I learn, I explore, I analyze, I design, then I assess. So only I assess, only I invisible. Other 4 are visible only. So tomorrow I will give you this ISS so that you can practice. Today you have to practice 4 sections, 4 topics. I learn, I explore, I analyze, then I design. You have to practice, understand the subject. Topic 1 is completed. You have to go through the topics and you have to complete it. So I have listened. You are listening to me. So Sudarshan Engineering College students, I know you are all very good students. You can easily understand the subject. So materials are given. These PPTs are available in the GBox portal. So you can easily understand. If you have doubt, you have mail ID. Sanbhavam having my mail ID. So you can share with other students also. Anything you need, explanation or materials and all, you can mail me. Then I'll share with you. But don't be idle. You have to do. You have to work. That is my request. Yes? Okay. Any other doubts, you can ask me. Otherwise, we can wind up this session. Do you have doubt? So tomorrow also we have a class. We can start finite automata. Today we stop the first topic. So far what we discussed, keep remember. One is the reduction, reduction, induction. Then formal proofs we discuss. Proof I said, contrapositive, contradiction, and then counter by example. These topics just remember. Same thing you can practice today itself. Right? I'll verify your performance. The e-box login. Thank you. Do you have doubt anything? We are going to wind up the session. Time is 10:31. Do you have any doubt? Any doubt? No doubt means we can wind up the session. Next class, I'm expecting your interaction. You have to speak with me. Definitely, you can ask me doubts. You have to speak. Use this platform. Basic practice. When you speak more and more times, then you can easily speak in any environment. Right? Another next class, you have to speak with me. I said, okay, no doubt. Clear. Thank you. Okay, we can wind up. Be ready next class. You have to speak with me. Okay, students, we can wind up the session. Thank you.